Hi guys, Paolo here, GT40 Model Works, and the model I would like to show you today is one of my upcoming masters that I think will be produced in the next months, better I used to say, you know, due to the pandemic situation. I absolutely have no idea when I can place this stuff in production, but I start preparing my own master, you know. And the model I would like to show you today is referred to a racing lady. It's a Callaway C7 RGT3 that raced, I think, 2018, 2017, 2016, 2018, 2019. And in the GT3 section, it was a heavily modified version of the Corvette C7R, that is already a wonderful and winning car. And as probably everybody of you already know, the nice model was made, the only model around of that Corvette was made by Revell, and it was this box. Here it is. I think everybody of us have it, and it is the same identical model provided by Revell Germany in a different box, bigger with a different box art, and I think something different in the decal, but I'm not so sure. Where the biggest issue of that model is mostly around the scale, because Revell and Monogram were used to work mostly 1:25 scale. Despite many of us have mostly collection in 1:24, it's a little number, you know, 24 to 25, but it's quite visible to notice this part. What I had to do here so was however a compromise with the parts, because of course it is meant not like a complete kit. It would be too expensive and too tricky and complicated to produce for me. But it's meant like a conversion kit for that Revell kit I showed you before. So my idea was to use anyway the dimension of the 1:24 scale. It was absolutely tricky to find the proper documentation. I tried to get in touch with the Callaway Facebook page company, but I absolutely had no help. Seems really that the guys don't give a damn about people outside there making model of their car, so they didn't help me at all. So I found my own dimension and blueprints about this car. It was not so difficult, you know, it was part of the documentation you can see behind the car, and it was something that I constantly use to make my proportion and my symmetry over my models, you know. And so, as I said before, it was meant like a transkit to be used over the Revell Monogram model. I still say Monogram, even if Monogram don't exist any longer, it's just Revell kit, or Revell USA, that don't exist any longer also, or Revell Germany, that is the only one producing the C7R. And my point is that anyway, the car can be placed together with 1:24 scale, because anyway, the enlargements that I did around the body are considering I don't know how to explain in English, but it's a proportion, you know, between what you have and the scale that you have to work with, keeping the proportion always stable together with the picture that you have of the actual vehicle. So what I will use here, and you cannot see in the video here because they're packed apart, it is wheels coming from the NSX GT3 that I already made. And they are made by OZ, if I don't mismatch the remembering, you know. I should have them here. Those are the wheels. And I designed the wheel arch around the 1:24. They are exactly 1:24 scale. This was a masterpiece made by KMP Andrea Brivio, and it works absolutely perfect in 3D, so they are 3D printed wheels in 1:24 scale, and they fit perfectly to the wheel arch of my model. So around the wheels I worked and rebuilt all the fenders. It was extremely tricky and complicated to maintain the symmetry of this car, you know, the colorway have these sharp lines and the sharp edges that are typical of extremely modern racer, as well as the internal roll cage is different from the ordinary Corvette. You may have built already the ordinary Revell kit, and you will remember how is the disposition of the roll cage. The cockpit is usually separated, and in the Callaway is open. The tubes inside are different, so the round of the tube is another type, and it's basically a completely different car, you know. The body is done. I still didn't complete it because before I need to have a brief talk with the customer, because this Callaway body have a lot of flares and vents here, you see, that they are with a lot of labels inside, so I still don't know if this label can be made apart, like a 3D part options, or cast it simply apart, because of course if I place the vents in the position, they will be damaged or destroyed, you know, during the casting process. So I think probably it will be better to make a small set apart of these vents and keep the body like it is now, just with the major holes, also easier to refine and also easier to paint, you know, because in some cars these vents are painted like in the MG GT3 Mercedes, they are painted in black. So it will be probably easier to have a part separated than together with the mold. So we have to see. We have to see also because also this side that you can see here, they are all featured with vents in the real car. So there is a lot of details still missing. The side pipe for the exhaust here, I have to replace it a little forward, but this is minor detail stuff that I can absolutely fix in a second time before the car goes to production, you know. Anyway, the body is done. I think the car is completely similar to the picture that we can find online of the actual Callaway. And there is already on the market some decals. I don't know why they did it from the slot racing companies, you know, the Caldoc and so on. I don't know if Fola made something. Maybe he did. But there is already something, because I guess there is around a 3D broad body printed of this Callaway that they use for a slot racing purpose. I think for a static model it is better to plan a production like in conventionally heavier racing, you know, than the ordinary slot body made in fiberglass or carbon fiber, you know. I think it's much more easy to work with them. With the ordinary resin, I mean, with the instead of the carbon fiber bodies for slots. That's it. I think the car is taken. I think the shape is taken. I like it a lot because it's a unique GT3 that nobody have in the collection. There is nothing around this car around, and probably there will be never something around, because it already seems to me that the car nearly doesn't race any longer, you know, since 1 or 2 years, and not for the pandemic. I didn't see any Callaway in the most recent competition, the most important competition around the world, you know. That's it. The body is usually modified, because from the ordinary Corvette you will find the bonnet completely different, the front air intake with completely different lines. The best should be, when you look at my video, if you have this Corvette, if you take the body in plastic that you have inside the car, you can see with your eyes which is the difference between what you see in my video and what you have in your hands, you know. And also this front spoiler is completely different, as well as all the side part, all the side fenders, all the side line, the air intake for the rear brakes is different. The tail is completely different, because the ordinary Corvette stops here. Instead, here we have a different rear diffusor, and all the vents here, also the line here over the wheel is different, because it closes this way with an opening with vents inside. Instead, the Corvette is just much more softer and wider. The width of the car is a little similar. This is, of course, much wider for these parts and so on, and I think is to be considered like a car in 124 scale than a car in 125 scale, the inner side remaining 125. So the inner dash and the inner mounting, probably part of the roof is in 24, but already 25, sorry, but already the part here have been modified and enlarged, so it becomes a little wider, in the area of 10-15%, you know, depending from the area. Of course, being a trans kit for that model, I had to work with compromises, but I think it's taken, and the car really look like a Callaway C7 GT3. That's it, guys. I hope you like the video, and see you in the next one.